Hey there, so now that you've learned how to do basic conditionals, we're going to look at doing advanced conditionals. Now, regular conditionals, one decision, two outcomes. Advanced conditionals, multiple outcomes. Pretty cool. So let's take a look. I want to go to the movies with my friends. It's been a long week. It's Friday night. I want to go hang out with my buddies. But the problem is my parents have a couple rules. Rule number one, room has to be clean. Rule number two, my homework has to be done. So in the past, all we know how to do is do rule number one. But now that we have two rules, how's that look? What we think that's going to actually end up being? Well, let's take a look at the diagram and see what that would look like. So first we had to say, is our room clean? If that was false, we're stuck at home cleaning our room. But if it's true, we go to another condition. Now, in the past, all we knew was cookie, no cookie, right? There's only two options. Now we have another condition. And that condition is our homework done? Okay. If it's not, we're stuck at home doing homework. But if it's true, we get what we want, which is to go to the movies. So what you'll see here is there's actually three different outcomes now because we have a conditional inside of a conditional, which is pretty neat. Now, notice that we have to get two trues in order to get to the end result that we want, whereas if we ever get a false, we have not only the options we don't want, but different options. So again, it allows us to get a lot of different decisions that we could possibly make based on the different inputs. So it really starts to make our drone look like it's a little more advanced. Now, what does this look like? All right, first of all, we're gonna start off with our if, our condition is our room clean, right? If that is false, then we gotta clean our room, right? But if it's true, we're gonna get another if with a new condition, which was our homework has to be done. If our homework is done, then we get to go to the movies. So we see that we have those ifs nested inside of each other, right? And you'll notice that they're indented, right? So that means that they're inside of it, a part of the outer condition, right? And then if we did not have our homework done, then we have to do our homework. So you'll see that that whole kind of if else in the middle with go to the movies and do homework is indented because it's all inside of that outside condition. We call this nested ifs or nested conditionals. Now, there's a lot of stuff going on here. And it can be very easy to lose track of our indentation and everything else. So there is another way with a few less lines of code. So let's take a look at it. Now, I have if, I have some condition. The difference with this one is I'm going to do the opposite of it. So this time I'm going to say, if my room is not clean, if it is not clean, then I need to clean it. Okay, here's the tricky part. This is called an else if, meaning that if that's not true, this condition is true. So it's a combination of else, which we know doesn't have a condition, and an if, which does. So it's kind of like another choice. In this case, this condition is going to be else if our room is not clean, right? If our room is not clean, I'm sorry, if our homework is not done, then we have to do our homework, right? And then finally, if neither of those ends up being true, we get to go to the movies. So it's a little bit of an opposite of how it works in the nested loops, but you'll notice that it's a lot shorter and simpler. There's only six lines, and we don't have to worry about all that indentation stuff. So you just have to think about kind of how things are laid out, right? So it has to get past those first two before it gets to the else, which is going to the movies, which is what we really want to do. So else if just allows me to do another condition without having to nest a whole loop, I'm sorry, a whole conditional inside of another conditional. It just allows me to keep going down the line. By the way, we can do ifs entirely on their own, but these are just other options that we can use to make it more complex, to get multiple outcomes. So that's more advanced conditionals. Let's go take a look at how we can use those in the program.